Would you be pissed? Or it's better that I wait till they die if I ask them for money? Okay. I mean, none of this shit makes any sense. I'm not mad about it. I just think that people need to chill, man. Like, just chill. I mean, like, I don't know. I don't like weed. It makes me feel paranoid, and I don't. Last I smoked weed, I was probably a teenager, and I didn't like it. But you probably need to smoke some weed. Maybe you'll like it, and it will help you. No. Yeah, I mean, Middle Eastern parents, Israeli, Arab, whatever, they help their kids. This not no entiendo nada. Sorry, I don't know that much Portuguese, but I can read it. Oh my God! Oh my God! Thank you, Mariah. You bought a badge. I really appreciate that. That's so cool. I always felt weird asking people for like badges, but I'm gonna start doing it. I'm gonna start, cause like, but when I'm creating off my live, cause I'm still gonna be privileged when you're on the live. And tomorrow I'm gonna wake up privileged, and guess what? I'm freaking grateful for that. But you know what? My parents worked their asses off. They worked so hard their whole lives, and I'm really grateful to them. And I tell God, thank you for this wonderful life and this wonderful family and for everything that you've provided for me, because my life is amazing and I'm happy. And I guess that kills people inside. Oh yeah, Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. I say Aussie. I don't even know how to pronounce it because I have that New Jersey accent. But like, you and the British people are super sarcastic. Oh my God, I'm so tired. I just got on. Sorry, I just got on the live really quick to say my big garage sale this weekend. This today. I had a great turnout. We had a great turnout, and it was like so cool to meet some of you guys. I really did the sale. It wasn't satire. The only satire part was like, oh, it's either sale or OnlyFans, because we know the only two jobs in existence now, as a millennial, I have to either get an OnlyFans or I have to sell shit from my house. So I chose to work only on the weekends. No, I'm kidding. But really, it was really great. I got to meet a lot of people. I got to. I know I look like crap. I'm so burnt from being outside, and I'm so tired, you know. But I it was like, yeah, I can't explain how cool it was to like know that people are interested. You know, of course, people are interested in my life, whatever, because it's like entertainment for people, but. It was really cool to just meet the faces behind the some of the Instagram names, some of the people that I've talked with before actually on Instagram that I got to meet face to face. And then yeah. I mean, I tried to you know, it's weird. It's because it's like part of being on TV or whatever is like you get a lot of negative stuff. Part of it is you get a lot of positive stuff. And I say that my life has gotten so much better, you know, since being on the TV show. I have so many opportunities open up for me. And I can't complain. I'm not complaining, but I just want to say, but like, what was weird, like when I went on TV, I was like, oh my God, like, I didn't give a crap about Instagram before I went on the show. I had like 200 followers. I never posted anything. I didn't know how to do, I don't know what a freaking hashtag was. But I had to learn real fast. That's not true. I knew about all that stuff, but I wasn't interested in it, just, you know, personally for my personal life. But so what I want to say is basically like, then I got into the Instagram world, and I, you know, and like being on the show, and I got all these followers. I remember when I had 3,000 followers when I was on the first season, the first couple episodes, and I was like, oh damn, 3,000? And now I've got like, what, 360,000 or something? So I get so much positive stuff, and my life has become so much better thanks to the show and everything. It's really true, but I do see like a lot of negativity. But it always like it amazed me in the beginning. I was like, these people have no sense of humor. Like, I'm nothing I say, pretty much nothing I say is serious. Everything I say is just satire or like, I'm just messing with people. I'll literally say, like half the stuff I say on the show, I'm literally just being sarcastic. And people are like I forgot there was one comment, right? I said to Landry, I was like, oh, work is overrated. That was fucking hilarious. But yeah, but people are like, oh my God, she's so spoiled. And it's like, yes, I'm very fortunate. I am very privileged. I'm very lucky. And I'm very happy about that. And I would not trade that for anything, right? I'm happy. I'm happy to be able to pass some of that privilege, some of those wonderful things on to my son. We shouldn't knock other people down who are successful or have good things. We should build up the people who don't have those good things. So that's what I have to say about that. So anyways, the point is, like, it was cool to me to be able to meet people today and put a face to some of the people. And you know what? I'm sure that there are people today at the sale that maybe don't like me on the show or they're mean on the internet about me. But when they got to meet me, see my family up close, they're like, oh, damn, this person is just a normal person that just happens to be on TV. She's not, like, totally conceited. She's not, like, I'm just moving boxes, selling stuff, some of my stuff for a dollar, you know. Not everything. Don't think you get everything for a dollar. But tomorrow, the sale continues. I'm freaking tired. The sun was really hot. It was really perfect. And I just had a really good time. It was super fun. Dr. Weinberg, the famous doctor, was there. And, I'm just a Jersey girl. I'm an Italian Jew from New Jersey. That's all you need to know. I'd rather fight one horse-sized duck. I'm starting at 9 a.m. tomorrow. But I'm, like, I guess being in the sun all day is like, tiring. And then, you know, just the constant, like, standing and the walking back and forth. So I'm going to start at 9. I have more stuff that wasn't out today. I'm going to put out more of my clothes. I'm actually thinking of doing an auction, not at the sale tomorrow, but I'm thinking of doing an auction for my white dress that got red wine on it, that I was so upset the day that the dress got wine spilled on it, because it was actually a gift to me from Tion, that dress. But if Tion gives me permission, because it was a gift from her, I might do an auction of the wine dress. Yeah, and I get super tired because I got a 2-year-old. And he doesn't let me sleep. He doesn't let me sleep. He's so good for other people. But so I think I want to auction off my wine dress. I also was thinking possibly to sell, like, on my page, like, some of the stuff I wore on the show, just for fun mostly. I don't know, but you know, obviously I want money. Everybody wants money. So I have the dress that I told Binny, I feel so sorry for you, and when I was in Kenya. And I have, what else? Oh my God, I got all that stuff. I have, like, my Prego. I have some great Prego dresses. So. you know, guys, like, I'm not ignoring you, but, you know, I can't answer some of those questions. But, yeah, so if you think, let me do this. So if you think that if you want to see an auction for the wine dress and other clothes that I wear on 90 Day Fiancé, then tell me. Oh, your son is born on December 17th. Yeah, he doesn't sleep when he's with me. Then when he goes over other people's house, grandma's house, my sister's house, they're like, oh my God, he's so good. He goes right to sleep. And he sleeps the whole night. I'm like, what? He doesn't do that for me. Maternity pants? I probably have, like, a bunch of maternity stuff I gotta go through. I have even more stuff that I didn't get out there. So I have a lot. I got the clothes, and I got so many books that, then there was we've sold so much houseware stuff, like kid stuff, you know, kids' clothes, men's clothes. I've had this one beautiful, like, so, no, I can't braid that well. I can't braid that well. Mostly whenever anyone's around that knows how to braid, I usually beg them to braid my hair for me. So anyone who knows how to braid, I'm always like, oh my God. He knows how to work his mommy. That's true. Like, it's so fresh. I haven't been creating as much stuff because I needed a break from Instagram and stuff. Because, like, honestly, like, it's just so draining sometimes. Oh, a lot of people, Christina, a lot of people came to the sale, and it was so fun. Like, it was just so fun. I'm not trying to answer negative people. I just wanna. I kind of feel like it's not that I want to answer negative people. What is it like? I kind of feel like if I talk to them, like they're human, like, and I'm like, yo, dude, what you're saying doesn't make sense. That they'll be like, oh man, yeah. But like, I'm always disappointed because people are freaking logical. Oh my God, my dad is the best. Oh my God, he's so fun. He's so cool. I can understand a lot of Italian, but I can't really speak besides like just generic phrases. I did study Italian though. Yeah. I know, Tion, right? Like, I can't with this Instagram stuff. It's so like stressful. In, yeah, it's totally stressful. I don't know. Like, even when you sometimes I get stressed out, even with positive stuff, because I'm like, oh man, so much to read or whatever, and I end up feeling like I'm focusing on my phone and not on Avi or whatever. So, Tion is super. She's good. Miss her a lot right now. Can't wait to see her. Yeah, Tiffany and Ronald, they were entertaining. I really liked watching Tiffany and Ronald when I got cast on the show. I was like, oh, I should probably know what the show, like, what's the deal with the show. So I binge watched The Other Way. I binge watched The Other Way, and I gotta be honest, when I watched Evelyn, I felt the same way a lot of you guys did, like, she's mean, whatever. But then I talked to her, and I think she's super. So I don't know. I guess maybe if I watched myself, I would maybe not like myself too. Yeah. Yeah, I know. I'm pretty positive. I'm pretty happy. Like, I'm. You know what? It's great. Like, when I was in my teenagers, I was so miserable. People ask me like about my scars on my arms. That was my miserableness of my teenage years, my hormones, feeling ugly, feeling unlovable. And then, you know, my 20s, kind of like, oh, I'm happy, but I don't know what I want to do. And like, you know, still that emotional kind of up and down. And now, like, in my 30s, like, I'm happy. Like, I can honestly say I'm happy and I like life and I'm got a great kid and I have good family and I'm grateful. And you know what have made me happier? Like, and I kind of always want to tell people, like, when I feel like they're stressed out, but then I'm like, oh, you can't force people to see something they're not ready for. But like, I'm grateful. Gratitude is what changed me, I think. Like, gratitude and I don't know, being a mom and like, I don't know, just like, and I like embracing, like, what's helping me a lot now is like mindfulness. It sounds kind of corny, but it really I was reading as I was talking, it really helps me. Like, I pray every morning, and just like the sound, like, it keeps me calm. And it's weird, like, I don't know, I'm just happy, and I'm empathetic. I've always been empathetic, but like, I try, when I'm someone upsets me, I try to be like, you know what, they got, it's not about me. It's not about me, right? And that's what's really cool. Yeah. I mean, it's funny sometimes being, yeah, the Ethiopian lifestyle too, and it's so like chill. You know, you always miss it when you're somewhere else. I know. But I back to sorry back to what I wanted to say about the sale. So it went great, and I got to meet so many cool people, and I really appreciated that. And I am going to auction off my wine dress, but there is no wine in it anymore because okay, so it's a white dress, and my thinking after the thing was like, fuck, This was a gift. Like, now I have to go home and Siona is going to see that, like, the gift she got me is destroyed. And I don't remember who did it. Well, I thought that it had been Sion who got it at this day and out, because I thought, but because my memory warps things, whatever. But I was like, didn't, or was it Binny or something? Someone I had, and then he was like, no, we sent it to like the cleaner or whatever. But I don't know. Anyways, the point is, it no longer has any wine in it. Like, some, I don't know. It's like, so it's amazing, but, and it's perfectly nice and usable dress. It's got a really cool fabric. But I'm going to auction it off. Ethiopia is amazing. The lifestyle, how I live there. I don't know how I live in the U.S. sometimes, to tell you the truth. It's so stressful here compared. Oh, I should auction off the wine, just with the bottle of wine. That is a great idea. Yeah, the sale is happening tomorrow. And I enjoyed, like, taking pictures with people. And I appreciated everyone who, like, just came out to support us. People drove from far. I had people drive from Connecticut to see me. And that was like, how can I not be happy? Like, that was super. And then we had from people from New York. So many people from Philly, from North Jersey, from Bayonne, from South Jersey. I mean, like, it was extremely flattering. It was extremely flattering for me. I love living in Ethiopia. Yeah, it was really hard for me. What they didn't show you when, you know, for time, whatever, they have to cut things, they have to edit it for time and neatness and all that. But when we went to the airport for me to leave, that was one of the hardest, like, even thinking about it was one of the hardest days of my life. Like, leaving Tion and leaving Ethiopia and thinking, like, I don't know when I'm coming back again. I don't know when I'm going to see them. And that was hysterical. Like, I was crying so bad. I just couldn't, like, I couldn't stop crying. And then, you know, Beanie was upset because he's thinking, like, oh, you're supposed to be excited. We're going to America. And I was like, I am, but I'm leaving all my friends and my, like, my country and everything, you know. And it was, like, a really hard reverse culture shock when we first got here. But I'm happy, but it was so hard. And, like, it was hard. It was really, really, really hard. And then going into the winter in the U.S., I haven't been in a winter in a long time. That was very hard too. I never had children. I was never married. So, but it was emotional. I mean, leaving Ethiopia was one of the hardest things. And it was silly because it's like, yeah, I could go back and forth. But, like, I don't know. At the time, it just seems like, when are you going to go back again? You know, that's everything. So, oh my God, thank you for saying, Donna, thank you for saying about my nephew. He was so excited to tell everyone that I did my sneakers. He's actually, he's starting his own, so my nephew is 11, he's starting his own custom painted sneaker business. So I want to support him, so I'm going to post my sneakers online on my story and stuff, and then anyone who wants to, like, order a custom pair, like, it's good. It's encouraging him about, you know, to be creative and to start his own small business. So I really want to get behind him and help him. He's a good kid. But yeah, life there is more laid back. You like my voice? I always hate my voice because it's kind of weird. It's really unique. But oh, I think you'll be great in Australia. I don't think you're gonna have issues. It was really nice to meet you too. I met so many people today. I was so overwhelmed. Like, I have not a million followers. I was going to say I have a million followers, but you know what I mean? Like, a lot of followers. And, like, but seeing people in person is a lot of people at one time, like, in one day, it was overwhelming, like, the support, you know? I sometimes think it's funny, like, when I'm in a public place and someone's like, I get stopped everywhere. Like, I wasn't prepared for that. Like, for example, so when the show first came out, I was in Ethiopia. So then, like, whatever. But then I went to the U.S. for obvious surgery. And I went to the supermarket. And I didn't wear any makeup. And I was in, like, plain pajamas. And I'm like, oh, yeah, no. At that time, I was I was kind of a mess. Anyways, at the supermarket, and then, like, these girls were, I was looking at them thinking, oh, they look like someone. And then they were like, I realized they're following me. And they're like, oh my God, is that you from the show? And that was kind of my first experience, like people wanted to see me because, like, I'm always been, it's gonna sound weird, but I've been kind of a private and like kept to myself, kind of like very social, love to meet people, but like, I don't know, usually when I travel less than when I'm in the States. So anyways, that was my first experience, like people want to see me and they want to know about me, and I'm like, it was weird. And then like, and then now, like, sometimes I'll see people and they'll be like, oh, like, are you okay, like, because they watch the show, and I'm like, I'm thinking, I'm fucking great. I'm so happy. Like, it's so funny for me. But yeah, it's like, I don't know. It's just the, I think I have a lot to tell people about, now in a society where you can easily go viral, and get overnight fame. Like, there's a lot to learn, and nobody really prepares you for it. But yeah, it's been a positive experience for me. Leandro's here. He's waiting for me. So I gotta go soon. Anyways, I don't want to, bore everybody to death. But oh, okay. So I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna shamelessly self-promote. So if you want to buy a badge to help support me, you can buy a badge, and I would appreciate that. And I'm gonna give a special shout out to anyone who does buy a badge. I think we're gonna be overrun with spam bots. I don't know why my lives always get these crazy spam bots. It's weird. I don't want you to follow me, spam bot. Ew. How do you get rid of these? Like, why did they attack your lives? Like, what's that about? And where do they come from? Does anyone know about this stuff? It's like totally overwhelming. Okay, dude, you need to like get out of here. Like these little the bots. I don't know the word. Don't make fun of me. Spam bot. That's probably not. So that doesn't even. That's not even a thing. Yeah. Is it because I have a lot of followers that these bots dude, I don't like you. You're a bot. You're a bot. Go away, bot. Go away, bot. I might have to end the live because of all the bots. But how do I let someone join the live? Just join. I don't understand what that means. Let them join the live. Okay. Anyways, tomorrow the sale continue. Oh my God, we had people buy badges. I didn't even see that. I want to thank everybody. Wait. Oh my God, how do I see who bought the badge so that I can think? Sorry guys, I'm learning, and Instagram's updated all these new things. Oh, I found it. Oh my God, New York GF, I want to say thank you so much. And Nurse J, thank you. And Kitsy Cat and Yaya. Mariah is a sap. Mariah, thank you, thank you. And Marielle, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. I would ignore it, but I think like it can negatively like impact you or whatever in some way, letting bots run loose on the live. But oh, I was gonna say, so tomorrow the sale continues. So please stop by if you're in the area, if you want to drive and come. I have more things to sell. I have more people to meet. And I'm really happy to have met all the amazing people I met today. And yes, more surgery for me, Lindsay. I need more surgery. So buy a badge and I will get some amazing plastic surgery. I'm gonna get huge boobs, a big butt, and come to my sale, and then I can do all that. And if you can't tell by now, I'm being sarcastic. And if you've been on this live for a while, you know that nothing I say is serious, and I'm always sarcastic. So please come. The sale went great today. I got to meet amazing people, and I got to pet some really cool dogs. And yeah, I look forward to meeting all of you tomorrow. So starting at 9 a.m. and going to probably like around 5. All right, love you guys. Bye, Giovanna. And have a really super good night. I'm tired and I just want to.